Anastasia anyway, so it's not like...
Oh, there's Anastasia.
Hi, everybody watching. Like,
Jesus Christ.
Like, oh, for fuck's sake.
Oh, my God. That rope is awesome.
Now it is a bit. What is it?
It's like a non-stop. It's like a non-stop just rolling over and over and over again. I don't know who the fuck it is, but we're gonna fucking move on. All right, hi everybody. Now that Anastasia's here, I'm done with this. Welcome to all your favorite game shows, everybody. I'm Paul Goble. I'm your host. We got a bunch of people in the chat. I'm so glad that you're all here to watch. We got a great show. This is our holiday spectacular. We've got a bunch of family teams playing together. They all know each other, and hopefully they all play and work well together. Thank you for joining us after our long break. As always, I never do this show on my own. I have to have some help. So here to help me out, give a big round of applause to my scorekeeper, my announcer. I'm his sidekick. It's Steve Mandel, everybody. Give him a hand.
And I'd just like to take this opportunity to wish everybody a happy life day. As you all know, today is the somethingth anniversary of the Star Trek Life Day holiday special. Came out in the 70s.
Yeah, so
live long and prosper, everyone.
Happy, now, wait a minute. I feel like you're being purposely confusing by mixing certain IPs.
I would never do that.
Where did you get that cool Star Trek shirt?
I won it at a game show, oddly enough.
Oh yeah, what was the show?
At the Scottsdale Film Festival a couple of years ago.
Oh nice.
Science fiction trivia.
And I noticed it's awfully big on you these days.
Yeah, because when I won it, I was about 70 pounds.
Well, at least they knew that the average sci-fi fan would need an extra large. Right. So that was smart of them. So what are you doing for Life Day, Steve, besides mixing IPs?
What do you mean by mixing IPs? This is one of my favorite memories as a Trekkie.
You're old enough, like me, to have watched the Star Wars Holiday Special when it was on TV. Did you watch it when it was on?
Star Wars Holiday Special?
The Life Day Holiday Special, sure. Sorry. Did you watch it?
I watch everything that includes Lumpy.
Yes, we all love Lumpy, our favorite Wookiee.
Our favorite Wookiee.
But did you watch it when you were a kid at the time?
Oh hell yeah.
Yeah, I remember watching it at the kid, and of course it's pretty bad, so really only kids could sit through it. But I remember watching it later as an adult and thinking, wait a minute, this was made and put on TV before streaming, before DVDs. And I was like, so what were they selling? The movies were already popular, right? What were they selling? And I remember watching it. And if you watch the original footage, every commercial is for a Star Wars toy. Every commercial throughout that special is for the new Star Wars toys that were coming out at Christmas time. And I saw that and I was like, oh, that makes perfect sense. Okay, there we go. They were all
recently, and I can tell you without a shadow of a doubt that what they were selling was pure cocaine.
Now, Star Wars characters aside, who is your favorite performance in the Star Wars Holiday Life Day Special?
Oh, B. Arthur, without a doubt.
Really? I like
Art Carney.
Yeah, I like Art Carney. He's my favorite.
I might be Art Carney. I have problems telling the two of them apart.
If you watch it, Art Carney's actually doing some very, very good acting. You can see he's very subtle. Oh, there's Anastasia's partner. All right. Hey, Austin, thanks for dressing up. All right. I guess we're all ready. Oh, Steve, didn't you just get back from Vegas?
I just got back from Vegas, and boy, are my arms tired.
And you went to the Omega Mart, right? How was that?
I went to the Omega Mart was incredible. I would recommend it to anybody that has lots
so
of
jealous.
Weird stuff.
Yeah, my wife went to the Meow Wolf in the first one. Where is it? New Mexico, and she
Santa Fe.
She won't shut up about it, but she really wants to go to the one in Vegas and then the one here that they're going to build. What have you been to any?
Built one in Denver.
Have you been to any other ones?
I've been one of Denver as well. I have not been to the other ones. I have not. I will now planning on getting out to Santa Fe and Denver next year.
Apparently, that's what happens when you go. You got to. Everybody wants to go see all the other ones. And did you wear a mask the whole time? Were you masked and vaxxed and waxed and ready to go?
I wore a mask while I was not eating or drinking.
Well, that's smart. All right. Well, are you ready to start the show?
I think I remember how to do this.
Is everybody else ready to start the show? Great. In that case, let's play The Price is Right. Steve? Who's playing?
Oh. Natalie, come on down. Come on down. Greg and Sarah, come on down. And this guy's not Alex. Come on down. Russ and Missy, come on down. Katie and Foster, come on down.
Oh my God. Is that everybody?
That is, should be everybody. Yep.
All right, there's a bit of a lag here, but we should be good. All right, we're going to play The Price is Right. You guys all know how that game works. I got some items here. I'm going to hold them up. Steve's going to describe them. All you got to do is tell me how much it cost me, and whoever gets the closest without going over will get a point. All right? Let's close this. We don't need this anymore. But the difference is between this and the actual Price is Right, the main difference is all these items are less than $5, all right? None of the things I am going to show you are worth more than $5, okay? So don't bid more than $5. I think I've made this abundantly clear. All right, Steve, tell everybody, what is the first item up for bids?
The first item up for bids is a box of whole buckwheat groats. According to the box, these groats are gluten-free as well as organic. Unfortunately, there is no information as to what a groat actually is.
So we've given away this prize many times. Nobody has ever been able to tell us what a groat actually is, but it's made from buckwheat and it's gluten-free. So let's go ahead and start with the grays. Clofton, Katie, what do you bid on this box of groats?
429.
$429, they say. All right. Natalie and David, what do you think?
Well, I think you're going to pay a premium for the gluten-free groats. So maybe $450?
$451. $451, they says the / Schaefer family. All right. Ed and Clee, you got a bid for us?
$299.
That's a very good bid. I like it. Very forceful. Sarah and Greg, what do you think this is worth?
I think we're going to go with $276.
$276.
Sarah's expertise.
Excellent. All right. Anastasia and Austin, what do you bid on this?
$350.
Okay, good bid. Russ and Missy, you're last. What do you think?
We're going to say, because it's backed by a little rascal,
$479. Steve, what's the actual
Everybody
price?
Here apparently has completely overvalued the growth.
What?
Everything has gone over the price.
Oh. All right, so everybody has overbid. Clearly, you guys love groats.
They're great.
No, they're not great. They're groat. What was the lowest? Steve, what was the lowest bid?
I believe it was 271.
All right, so do not bid more than 271 this time. Start again. Grays, what do you say?
179.
179. I like that bid. David and Natalie.
1 cent, Bob.
1 cent. They went down low. All right. Ed and Clee, what do you think?
I think
85 cents.
I think 79 cents.
79 cents?
Yes.
79 cents.
All right. Nice. I like the way you guys work. Sarah and Greg, they're discussing it.
We're going to go with 60 cents, Paul.
60 cents. I love it. All right. Anastasia and Austin, what do you think?
99 cents.
99, like I got it at the 99 cents store, possibly. All right. And Missy and Russ, what do you think?
So what do you say, 159? Is that out there?
Is that available, Steve?
No, that is available.
All right.
We're taking it.
All right, they're going to go 159. Steve, who gets the groat?
The actual retail price is $2.50. Clofton and Katie are
our winners. Ah, way to go, the Gray family. You know your groats. All right, that's 1 point for you guys. Keep
also,
in mind.
I'm sure that's a good thing.
A groat is slightly larger than an oat.
Oh, so it's like a great oat. Groat.
It's a growing oat.
A grown oat.
Terrible poor man's oat. I hate it.
Makes just as much sense as anything I've heard. All right. Steve, what's the next item up for bids?
The next item is a dented can of jellied cranberry sauce. Ooh. Why not start the holidays off right by risking salmonella?
Or botulism, which is, you can see the dent right there at the bottom. I actually bought this last...
What that means?
Well, it could... No, if it's dented, then you shouldn't eat it because it's probably got... But if it's bloated, it's botulism. But in this case, it says open other end. Oh, okay.
I've been eating dented cans my whole life.
Well, you shouldn't you shouldn't be eating cans at all. Cans are not good for you unless you're a goat.
I was eating a dented can.
No, don't eat any cans at all, dented or otherwise. It's bad for you. All right, so the Grays got that last one. So David and Natalie, you get to bid first. What do you think I paid for this can of dented cranberry sauce?
Just say $109, Bob.
109, they say. All right. Ed and Clee, what do you think?
50 cents.
50 cents. All right. Good bid. Sarah and Greg?
All right. We're going to go with 35 cents.
Wow. Down low. Look at that close up of that dent. Gorgeous. All right. Anastasia.
Oh, yeah. That's a lot.
Right?
That's a lot.
Deep. Deep. Anastasia and Austin, what's your bid? What do you think?
50 cents.
You're going 50 cents? All right. And Russ and Missy?
That was our bid.
That was your bid.
Yeah.
Oh.
45 cents. Then.
Okay. So the ANA says 45. And the Mionkeys team, what do you think? That's you guys. Russ and Missy, you're the Mionkeys. That's who you guys are, the Mionkeys.
As fans of food that take the shape of its container, we're going to say 29 cents? 29 cents.
29. All right. I don't think anyone overbid this time. Steve, what's the deal?
I think Clofton and Katie have to bid.
Oh, that's right. They didn't bid yet. Sorry, guys. What's your bid?
10 cents.
All right. They went down low.
All right. So they didn't need to bid after all. The actual retail price is $1.89. David and Natalie are winners.
There we go. David and Natalie got themselves a point.
I'm sorry. Look, I'm sorry, Austin. I'm sorry. You were right.
Well, good thing you guys aren't in the same room. All right. All right. So that's another point on the board. Steve, what's next?
The next item up for bids is a salt shaker that looks like a stereotypical hula girl, made in China and bought with regret. It's perfect for your relative who thinks getting laid is a funny thing to say.
All right, so look at this hula girl. She's empty right now, but she's got two holes in her head. So Ed and Clee, you bid first. What do you think I paid for this?
Hollywood.
What'd you say?
162.
162, is that your bid?
Yes.
All right, I love it. Okay. Sarah and Greg, what do you think?
We're gonna go with 125, Paul.
125. Nice bid.
Like business like.
I like that he's very professional. Keeps it serious.
Yes, no, we take this game very seriously. I just want you to know that.
Look at they dressed up. They're in a studio. They got professional equipment. Come on, Katie and Clark.
It's
attention.
My basement.
Yeah, we're in his basement right now, literally. So.
All right. It works for me.
A lot during COVID.
Anastasia and Austin, what do you think I paid for this?
$2.47.
Okay. Missy and Russ, what's your bid?
We have questions. What's the material?
I think it's ceramic, but very cheap ceramic. It's made in China. So there you go. That's the noise it makes on wood.
Ah, okay. $199.
All right, $199 from the Meowkies. Team Gray, what do you say?
$357.
$357 Magnum from Dirty Harry. All right, good bid. Natalie and David, you bid last.
Follow-up question, was it part of a set?
Yes, it was part of a set.
What? You can ask follow-up questions.
So wait, are we bidding? Are we guessing how much you paid for the set or for the salt shaker?
Just the salt shaker, according to the description.
$248.
$248 is their final bid. Steve, who gets the salt?
The actual retail price is $1.49. Greg and Sarah are winning.
Yeah!
Good job. Oh shit! Did I forget to switch this to Price is Right? Okay, there we go. I forgot to switch that over. All right, good job, Greg and Sarah. Got yourself a point. You're on the board. What's next, Steve?
Next item up for bid is a teeny Aquaman figure that Paul has been trying to get me to take home for over 2 years now. What does this say about a man that he is so determined to make a joke work? A joke that he fully knows only he will find amusing.
Good question, Steve.
Is that
Steve.
What we're bidding on?
Yes, it's a. You can see it's kind of small.
And not even Jason Momoa.
It's small,
the joke,
yes.
Or
it's...
the Momoa.
Both.
Bada bing.
So you see how small it is? It fits right here, but it's the original Arthur Curry, blonde-haired, green and orange outfit. All right, and yes, it's true. This was originally something I tried to force on Steve. He has refused it every single time. So who got it last, Sarah and Greg?
Sarah and Greg got it last.
Okay, so Anastasia and Austin, you bid first on this little Aquaman.
Oh no, it seems too soon.
Look how little. Look how cute.
I think we're gonna go with 235.
235? Did you say 235? Yeah. All right. Missy and Russ, what do you bid on Aquaman?
Oh my God! From our perspective, we're just seeing Arthur Curry's crotch.
Yeah, sure. AC baby.
ACC. $1.
I didn't know Aquaman was Jewish. Okay, $1 from Russ and Missy. Hey, you got a roast for Aquaman?
That's not a diving pool.
Russ, you want to give Aquaman a quick roast while he's here?
Oh, I can't remember.
I know you're a fan. All right. Clifton and Katie, what do you bid on this?
$1.79.
$1.79 from the Grays. Natalie and David?
$2.99.
Ed and Clee?
$1.16.
$1.16. Excellent. And Sarah and Greg, you're last. What do you think?
Has $1.49 been said?
I don't think so, Steve.
Okay.
All right, Steve, that's all the bids. Who's getting this Aquaman?
The actual retail price was $325. David and Natalie win.
Oh, again, David and Natalie chalking up another point. Well done.
That's Aquaman.
Aquaman's going to be swimming in cranberry sauce.
The Red Sea! I'm in the Red Sea. And he's got a girlfriend too, huh? Ooh, hula hula hula. Actually, Steve, we got a surprise for you. What's the next item, Steve?
This last item up for bids is a pepper shaker that looks like a stereotypical hula girl. Made in China and bought with regret. It's perfect for your relative who thinks getting laid is a funny thing to say.
So this is identical to the other one. Even it's got the same amount of holes on top, so you don't know what's what.
But it's different?
No, it's identical. There's literally nothing. Well, maybe this has a stain on it, but otherwise they're exactly the same.
Ew.
It's a pepper stain.
S for stain, S for salt. That's how you know.
All right. Who got it? David and Natalie. So Ed and Clee, you bid on this one. If you remember how much the last one was worth, that's probably a smart bid.
Can we ask how much the last one was?
Yeah, you can ask all day long.
Uh,
Are you gonna answer?
Fuck no. I don't have answers. I have only questions. Steve's got all the answers.
Steve,
it was
28
galactic credits, but I don't remember the
225 from Ed and Klee. Okay, Sarah and Greg, what do you think? I don't know. I'm gonna hold them both up.
Going high this time. I'm gonna say 475.
Wow!
Wow! Much more expensive than the other one for some reason. Anastasia and Austin, what are you gonna bid?
245.
245. All right. Russ and Missy, what do you say?
350.
350. Clofton and Katie.
$1.49.
$1.49, she says. And David and Natalie, currently in the lead, what do you say?
$1.48, I guess.
$1.48, says Mr. Memory. Okay. Steve, what do you think? Who got it?
The actual retail price was, in fact, $1.49. The Grays win it.
Well done. They went back to Twitch and, like, rewound it and watched. So very smart.
For the echo. Just with Twitch on the whole time.
Yeah, very wise. All right, so we got some points scored in that round. Good job, everybody. How about a round of applause? That is the end of the Price is Right round. Steve, you want to take a break and meet our contestants?
Sure.
Okay, who's playing the game tonight?
David Bax and Natalie Schaefer, a married couple from Los Angeles who together host The One Where I Met Your Mother, podcast comparing and contrasting Friends and How I Met Your Mother, obviously.
Obviously. I like how your description of your podcast is very condescending, just like you. Now, David, you've been in the podcasting game for a while. You and I used to do a show together, and I remember one of the reasons we stopped doing it, not just because I moved away, but also because you had to devote more time to movies and weren't watching as much television. What was it that made you decide? I'm sure the pandemic had something to do with it, but what was it that made you decide to
all the movie theaters closed for over a year? That's what happened.
And you came running back. You came running back, you son of a bitch. And my phone was fucking blowing up. Please do a podcast with me, please. I said, it's over, David. It's over. Find someone better. And he did. So go into more detail about this podcast you guys do.
Well, the basic idea came from, I'm a big How I Met Your Mother fan who managed to mostly ignore Friends while it was on because I was a too snobby, like, you know, art, film, punk rock kid or whatever.
Well, you certainly look like all three of those things.
She was just not me to ever get into How I Met Your Mother, so she knows Friends very well. So we decided to. So we're doing a show where we're watching, you know, season 1, episode 1. You know, we're
okay
keeping pace, and each of us is the expert on each show.
More or less, yeah.
Okay, so I have anything out? So I have two questions. One, how far along are you in the shows?
We literally just yesterday posted the season 1 finale of Friends. There are more Friends episodes than How I Met Your Mother episodes, so we
had to supplement it.
Yeah, so instead we also talked about a couple episodes of the Food Network program Mystery Diners, which is the show that we are experts in.
Yeah, apparently that's your expert
the worst
category.
And best show to ever be on television.
Okay, well now let me ask you this. Knowing how those shows end, especially How I Met Your Mother, it really was kind of a twist ending that they were keeping hidden for a long time. Knowing now what happens...
Reason ruin it for Natalie.
I'm saying knowing now, you both know how both those shows end. How is that...
No, we just watched the season 1 finale, I'm saying.
I'm saying in the...
We've only finished season 1.
But you know how I Met Your Mother ends, correct?
I know.
Okay, and Natalie, you know how Friends ends, correct? Okay, so my question is, does that inform your decision when you're saying, oh, this wasn't my favorite episode, or yes, it is my favorite episode, or do you have to stop yourself from ruining things for the other dummy?
Yes. the latter. We stop ourselves from ruining it for the other, I think.
But okay. I think we also do like fun, like foreshadowing, like, yeah. Like, oh, somebody,
pay attention to
yeah, Marshall slapped somebody in this episode. There's going to be more Marshall slapping people coming out.
Well, that's a little different. You're not really ruining anything so much as you are just setting up a fun joke. But I mean, like How I Met Your Mother, there's a lot of stuff to ruin. Friends, not so much, but How I Met Your Mother, there's a lot of shit to ruin there. So how many times have you had to stop yourself?
Like you said, I've been in the podcasting game a long time. I know how to.
You're right. You know, and you're a movie guy too, so you're very aware of spoilers, I guess.
Spoilers, yeah.
Now, Natalie, did you know that was Bob Saget?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
Yes, I did.
Have you guys heard?
I watched Full House.
Have you heard they revived the How I Met Your Father pilot?
Yeah, with
Hillary Duff.
Hillary Duff.
Yeah, Hillary Duff and Kim Cattrall is the Bob.
Right? Originally it was Greta Gerwig, which is why it didn't get picked up because she's so terrible. But now they've revived it with Hillary Duff.
Who to you?
And Kim Cattrall. Oh, remember your favorite movie, Francis? Ha ha! I stole $12 from you by making you come see this movie. I know that's your favorite Greta Gerwig movie.
We love Francis Ha.
I actually love that movie.
All right, well, this conversation's over. David and Natalie, thanks for playing, guys. Thanks for being here. Steve, who's
check
next?
The one where I met your mother. Sorry.
Oh, wait. Do you want to tell people where to find it as if people don't know where to find a podcast?
It's called The One Where I Met Your Mother. You can find it where you find podcasts, and you can also find it at battleshippretension.com, which is my movie review website.
That's the best place to go for all your BP needs. All right. Who's next, Steve?
Lee Wiggins and Ed Greer are two comedy nerds who regularly make multiple podcast appearances, including Ed's podcast, The Greatest Pod.
Oh, great. I think I wrote that. Hi, guys. Welcome back to the show. Now, you've both been on the show before individually. Is that correct?
Yeah.
But this is the...
I was on first, and then you asked me if I would ask Ed if he would do the show.
Well, because I know from experience that Ed is like the Bill Murray of LA comics. He's impossible to get a hold of. So... asking his wife is the best way to get a hold of him, and you seem happy to do it apparently. So I it's not like you go, hey asshole, I'm not his secretary, do it yourself.
Although it's like Wes Anderson asking. Once he shows up, he's happy to be there. But
right,
getting him to come is the problem.
He's always great every time he shows up. He's dynamite 100% every performance. That's why we put up with it. That's why we put up with it. So what are the podcasts that you guys are currently involved in?
What other podcasts? I do the Schmodown, Movie Trivia Schmodown. I'm on Team Corruption. I also have regularly appeared. It's been like about a year and a half. But I did the Star Wars Minute.
Oh, yeah. That's a good show. The Star Wars Minute's very fun. And
that's a fun ass show.
And Ed, what about you?
I'm doing The Greatest Pod, and I'm actively keeping her off of The Greatest Pod because I want it to be fun.
Wow.
You know how couples are. It becomes this like cut you down session. Like, oh, I've been taking your karate class for 5 years. Let me beat your ass in front of people, and I can't take it. I can't take it. I don't like it. So I keep her away from myself.
Oh, I get it.
This veneer of invincibility on my own shows, for Christ's sake. So, but because she'll just destroy that.
Because
so.
You can pretend. But, yeah, it's good.
That's what you think.
Well, it's funny because there are two of the teams tonight do podcasts as their couples and their podcasting partners. I know, you know, Natalie, Sarah and Greg have been podcasting together for about 100 years. So we'll see if that's the case when we talk to them, how much they roast each other. but you do you still do that podcast with Ron that nerd podcast, Ed, with Ron Swallow, that one. What is that one?
Yeah, that one. That one's called The Greatest Pod.
Oh, that's it.
Used to be called Nerd Goat, but right. We were the network, and they kind of owned the name, and then we had to kind of get out of there, like,
Nerd Goat
Image Comics and leave.
All right. Well, that's all right. And so, okay. And I'm betting all those podcasts you mentioned are available at iTunes and all your other podcasting locations.
And yes, everywhere, even Spreaker and the weird ones.
Do you have a website? Do you have like one place, a website or something where everybody can find that stuff?
Yeah, you could go to just search The Greatest Pod, and it'll take you to our Podbean, our regular website, or it'll take you to some place to listen to it.
All right, excellent. Okay, thank you guys for being here. Let me give you an applause. There it is. Steve, who's next on the list?
Sarah X. Dillon and Greg Nibbler are the hosts of Fun Employment Radio, a daily Portland podcast broadcasting since 2009. The show is about local personalities and radio veterans, Greg and Sarah, as they live life in Portland, as well as interviews with special guests, plus news, current events, and more.
I got all that off of your website.
Okay, I was going to say, that's a lot.
No, that's not what you guys sent me. I did that one. But 2009, you've been podcasting.
I took time to send that to you, Paul.
You've been podcasting and working together since 2009, and you're also a couple in the biblical sense. Now, which was it?
We're not a couple in the biblical sense.
Wait, you guys have never been a couple?
No, we're not a couple. I mean, we're in small rooms together a lot. No.
So it's all business, is what you're saying. Yeah, with you guys, it's all business.
Yeah, but we actually work. And we worked together actually before that for a couple of years in commercial radio, and that's actually where we met. And then when we got laid off, we started, you know, Fun Employment Radio,
right?
The name, and now it's kind of stuck, and it's like the longest name ever.
And so, you've been doing it for quite a while. Well, that's probably how you've been doing it, being so successful for so long, is that you don't live together or have sex with each other. So that probably helps.
Perfect.
Yeah, that probably works out.
Oh,
so,
you just have a way with words. I love it.
So there you go, Clee and Ed. Once you guys break up, have her on the show all the time. That's clearly.
You can do a show with someone and have the option not to have sex with them.
That's what I've heard.
I was not informed when I agreed to this.
Yeah. I kept that on the DL for a reason, Steve. But so you guys have been doing your show for a long, long time. I was on it a million years ago, and a lot of my friends have been on it. But you're like a Portland staple now. Like, people talk about all the things like riots and free drugs and you guys. That's all the great things about Portland,
we're
right?
Diving
the city down, but we're still going.
I know. And we do have to say our favorite guest we ever did have on the show is Paul Goebel.
Oh, absolutely.
That's fucking bullshit.
Of course.
In all the 12 years.
That's ridiculous. That's very nice of you to say that. But
no, because we got to meet you during Bridgetown Comedy Festival, and that was super fun.
That actually, meeting you guys and hanging out there at Bridgetown was one of the best fucking weekends of my life, without a doubt.
It was so fucking fun.
Yeah.
We love you, buddy. Thank you for asking. I wish we could
still keep doing that. So obviously people can Google Fun Employment Radio to find out more about you guys, but is there other places and other things you want people to know about?
I mean, that's it. You know, you can listen to podcasts anywhere you can find podcasts.
All right.
Like Ed was saying, all the weird ones are on there as well.
And so there's also
Snatcher.net or, you know, whatever. We're there.
So is there also a video component, judging by your setup?
Yeah,
we do have a video setup that's for our Fun Employment Radio Supporters Club members.
Nice. That's right.
Yeah,
getting that money.
You know, YouTube and all that stuff.
This is Greg's other company set, though.
Another one, yeah.
Damn.
This isn't our normal podcast set. It's another set.
You're like a regular Mark Cuban. All right.
Yeah.
Well,
Mark Cuban of Portland. A lot of people say that.
He's Mark Cuban of Portland. All right, guys. Thank you very much for being here, guys. Steve, who's up next?
Anastasia Washington is a comedian and actress who loves ghosts, food, true crime, and all things nerdy. Austin is her mother.
Okay. So, originally.
I'm proud of you, baby girl.
Calm down. Wait, let me switch this to interviewing the contestants. Okay, there we go. So originally, Anastasia and her mom were supposed to be on the show. They were going to be the one team that wasn't like sleeping or working together. It didn't turn out. Anastasia, what happened? Where is your mom? Why couldn't she make it?
she is on the set of The Flight Attendant.
Damn.
Ooh,
nice. Nice.
So yeah. What does she do? What is she doing on that show?
I mean, she's working as something. I don't know.
You have no idea what she does for a living?
I don't know. I have no idea what anybody's doing anymore.
All right. Well, so your mom works on The Flight Attendant. That's good. But you were able to make it. So introduce us to who is filling in for your mom tonight.
The next best thing to my mom is the person that acts the closest to my mom, Austin Warren.
Hi, Austin. Welcome to the show. We appreciate filling in at the last minute.
It's like I'm dating my mom. It's basically the same personality.
Okay. Now, why not your dad? Why isn't he like your dad? Because he probably has more.
Not.
He probably has more in common. Here? Oh, okay. Because he picks up when you call. All right, I hear you. I know what you're saying. I dig it. So you guys are a couple. Do you also work together besides playing together?
No. Yeah, we've done some stand-up shows together. We're both stand-up comedians. We met doing a stand-up show together.
And have you
live in a hopeless place?
Have you talked about doing a act together, like Elaine May, Mike Nichols possible thing?
Listen, we're gonna do a full musical review with a
nice
tap number.
Nice,
it's coming.
All right.
He doesn't know. I never informed him of this.
Go to your room.
I told you it's like dating my mom.
I like that. I wish. Try to get my wife to send me to my room all the time. But she's like, no, you need to get a job. All right, so do you guys do a podcast together? And if not, why not? What the fuck's wrong with you?
We don't. I think I do enough podcasts for the world. so.
All right.
But
what are some of the podcasts we could hear you on?
You can hear me at Serial Killer, which is like the breakfast cereal, not like... And we pair breakfast cereal with true crime.
I love it.
As you do. So that you can hear me on that. And you can hear me on You Can't Do That Anymore, which is a podcast where we talk about classic movies and what you probably shouldn't happen anymore in them.
I see, yeah.
But yeah, whether or not so we talk about it.
Yeah.
It's weird.
That's very common. It's weird. You watch an old movie that you liked and you're like, and all of a sudden you go, oh, I remember that scene being like that. I don't really enjoy that anymore. I remember when my kids were little, I was like, hey, you guys want to watch Eddie Murphy Delirious? It's fucking hysterical. I remember when I was in high school, man, I laughed so hard. And then we're sitting down and he's like saying faggots a million times. I'm like, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I forgot
weird
about
science.
This part.
Weird science.
Weird science, yeah.
Yeah, it's not good for anybody, really. nobody's represented nicely.
When Kelly LeBrock steps out of the bathroom and all the steam, you're like, well, can't you guys sit down and talk to her for 10 minutes first? Just get to know her?
Nah,
not going to happen. all right, well, we can't wait to see you guys do a podcast. Here's my suggestion.
I'm sure it'll come.
Every week you guys get together and Anastasia, you tell Austin what you did that week and he tells you why what you did was a mistake. That's that's the podcast that you guys should do. You can have it. Free idea. I won't even sue you for it. All right. Thanks for being here, guys. We appreciate it. Steve, anyone else left on the list?
Sure.
Who is it?
Russ Kazmierczyk Jr. is the creator and self-publisher of Amazing Arizona Comics, a mini-comic that satirizes Arizona news, history, and culture with superhero adventure. Missy Pruitt is the owner and proprietor of the Lagatara Cat Cafe and Boutique, which is home more than 600 cats.
Isn't it Lagatara? How do you say it, Missy? Lagatara?
Lagatara.
Okay.
I'm still recovering from saying Russ's last name.
Yeah, you need a break. You need a good 2 days in there to recover. Hi, guys. Welcome to the show. It's so nice to have you on. Russ, you've been on the show many times, but Missy, this is your first time. How do you feel? I know you were a little nervous. How is it being in front of the camera?
Perfect.
For those of you who don't know, because Missy runs the Cat Cafe and she's the crazy cat lady, She likes to say purr and meow and stuff like that. so I've named their team the Meowkies because Russ is a huge Monkees fan. Now, the, I know you guys went and saw the current Monkees on their latest tour. How many times did you go see them?
Only three.
Only three in this latest tour.
Correct.
Now, how you Russ, how many times have you seen an act that was called the Monkees live?
I've seen some incarnation of the Monkees probably 18 times.
Damn, that's a lot of Monkees. And it's more than 12. And Missy, you've seen them how many times?
Three.
The three that you guys saw after you started dating.
Yes.
So did you know that this was coming when you decided to start dating Russ? Did you see, oh no, I'm going to have to go to every Monkees concert?
I don't even think I knew who the Monkees were.
Wow.
Well, there's so, a podcast right there. Monkeesplain.
Monkeesplain, yes. You guys watch a Monkees episode, and then Missy goes, what the fuck was that? And Russ goes, well, here's why it was good.
And then, it's with the screening of the movie Head, where Missy's head blows
up. Yeah. Through that. Has he made you watch Head yet, Missy? Has he made you watch Head yet?
Not yet.
Russ, what's the plan there?
Well, I want to keep getting it. So I'm delaying the...
No, that's fair. That's totally fair. It's not the greatest movie.
She looks at me and says, Victor Mature?
Right, she recognizes Victor Mature. Oh, he's my favorite. But you, as you said, as Steve said in the opening intro, you publish your own comic book that is about Arizona stuff. Tell people about that.
Well, I'm working on issue 47 right now, so I've been self-publishing it for the last 11 years or so. But it does star local superheroes like June Monsoon, the Living Monsoon Storm, or the Dust Devil,
nice.
Or Speed Cameron, who is a human speed camera.
I love
it. And the story is inspired by local news and culture here in Arizona. Right now, I'm actually working on an issue that exposes the chicken wars, the fast food chicken wars that have so gripped our nation and the world.
Are you going to mention how almost every KFC is actually a meth lab?
I'm going deep into the, I think that's the 12th herb.
The colonel that fucking went off the rails since he died. And Missy
wasn't quite started.
All right. Now, Missy, you're not just a crazy cat lady. You rescue cats and home them, and you've devoted your life pretty much to this thing. So tell people about what you do. Who people don't know what crazy cat ladies do.
Oh, man. Just that. I rescue cats every day. It's a, I don't know. Can you tell them?
I can't tell you, Paul. The last two Monkees concerts we saw, one was in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
One was in St. Louis.
Yeah.
Both times on the way back, she gets a call like she's the A-team of cat rescue.
Right.
They consult her. Seriously, Stephen Cannell missed an opportunity. She gets a call. She consults these folks, and it's a myriad of things. It's either somebody that's going to get evicted because they've hoarded too many cats.
Mm-hmm.
It's some parents have maybe one cat too many for the sake of their own health. A bunch of reasons. They find Missy somehow through the Phoenix underworld. And she, I swear, this is what happens. She doesn't know these people from Adam. They find her name. Somebody whispered Missy's name in an alley. They find
the back of the car. So if you have a cat and you need to home it and you can find her, call the Missy team.
All the local rescues and coordinates and networks with them and gets them fixed. And
that's awesome.
And finds them homes. It's incredible.
That's so great. Yeah, you do a great job. We're all of us cat fans really appreciate what you do. Speaking of hoarding, did you guys hear about that deaf guy who had a bunch of fish in his house? He was hoarding herring. Anyways, thanks for being here, guys. Russ and Missy, give them a hand. Thanks a lot. I just wrote that joke tonight. Steve, who's left?
Katie and Clofton Gray are a married couple who are vigorously involved in the sport of roller derby with an Arizona Derby with the Arizona Derby Dames. They are both involved in their live events in Phoenix this Saturday when the Men in Black face off against the aliens.
So you guys have a bout, as you call it, this Saturday. What are you doing at the bout, Katie?
I am head ref for the first bout, and then I'm game executioner for the main, the aliens versus Men in Black. The game executioner gets to murder anyone who offends me.
Oh, nice. So in the first game, you're all about the rules. In the second game, you're say fuck the rules.
Exactly.
Nice.
Exactly.
And Clofton, what are you doing there, Buttman?
I forgot we did that. I can't see it. Oh yeah. So I'm one of the head announcers for the league. So I announce, and I'm also going to be singing the national anthem beforehand because they asked me to do that too.
That's so nice. Are you excited or are you nervous about the national anthem?
No, I am not. The national anthem. I've tried out for the national anthem at Suns games and stuff just for the heck of it.
Oh, okay.
When you say the national anthem, will you actually be singing Mr. Roboto?
Well, I am the modern man.
The Clofton pre One Nation Under Grudge. That's the national anthem. The game is this Saturday if you're local here in Phoenix. But if people want to learn more just about your bouts and the whole league, where should they go?
If you're on social media, Facebook, Arizona Derby Dames, but there's also the ArizonaDerbyDames.com. I don't know how updated the website is. Is that terrible?
Well,
a little bit.
Speaking of Facebook, are you still in Facebook jail, Katie?
No, I was released.
Do you want to tell everybody why you got thrown in Facebook jail?
Clifton decided to post my wrong use of there, and
I screen grabbed. She used the wrong instance of the word there.
Uh huh.
And I screen grabbed it and posted it to prove that she had edited her comment to fix it.
Wow.
I'm a punch you in the grundle.
And so Facebook censored you because you said you were gonna punch him in the grundle.
Grundles are very sensitive. Wow.
Better than getting punched in the groat.
Especially online.
Could have threatened to punch me in the groat.
I grundled my groat! Oh my god! All right. Well, I appreciate you guys.
I'm in Facebook jail right now, so that's fun.
Oh yeah, that's right, because you called somebody a rat nest or some shit.
I called two people plague rats and plague bringers.
Because they refused to get
their grundles at all.
Nice.
I didn't threaten their grundles.
Their grundle is full of COVID. Okay. Is that it, Steve? Are we done with that now?
We are done with that now.
Excellent. All right. Let's go ahead and move on to our next game. Let me switch it over. Our next game is, of course, the match game. Where is it? There it is. We all know how we play the match game, all right? Get your whiteboards and pens and whatever ready. The way it works is I have a bunch of questions here. I'm going to ask them. They all have a blank in them. Once I ask them, you guys have to fill in the blank with your best answer. Then once it's done, once you guys write your answers down, I'm going to go to Steve, and I'm going to ask him to fill in the blank. So you're trying to match Steve, all right? You want to try to figure out what Steve's going to say. Everybody who matches Steve gets 1 point, and I will also give a point to the most popular answer. All right, so, and if you match Steve and it's the most popular answer, you get 3 points. So this is a good opportunity to really bank some points and shoot ahead. All right, we all know how it goes. All right, excellent. Here is your first match game question. I hate the way Mr. Refrigerator treats Mrs. Refrigerator. Every night, he leaves her blank. I hate the way Mr. Refrigerator treats Mrs. Refrigerator. Every night, he leaves her blank. This one is right off of an episode of Match Game. And there were many answers. So confer with your partner. Write down the best answer you could come up with. I didn't realize that the conferences were going to add time to this. All right. All right. So everybody got their answer written down? Great. Steve, I hate the way Mr. Refrigerator treats Mrs. Refrigerator because every night he leaves her... He leaves her cold. Yes, I think that makes sense. All right, so cold is the answer we're looking for. Katie and Clofton, every night he leaves her, what did you say? Cold, there we go. Excellent, all right, there's a point. Good job. Natalie and David, what'd you say? We're looking for cold.
Crisper open.
He leaves her crisper open. Is crisper a euphemism for something?
Oh, yeah, I think you know. I think you
All right. How dare you call me out like that. Okay, Ed and Klee, we're looking for open. What did you say?
Looking for cold.
Oh, cold, that's right. Not open, cold. That's right, leaves are cold. All right, good job. So far, that is the most popular answer.
I'm glad nobody said meat drawer.
He leaves her meat drawer open.
Not yet.
The night is young.
Every night. Why is he leaving her meat drawer open? That's the disconcerting part. Woman doesn't in control of her own meat drawer. All right, Greg and Sarah, we're looking for cold. What did you guys say?
All right, maybe he did say cold, but I went with empty.
Oh, you said empty. Nice. Cold, empty, not a match. Very close. All right, Anastasia and Austin, what do you think? We're looking for cold. What did you guys say?
I mean, maybe somebody said...
Oh, another open. All right.
Maybe somebody said we should have gone with cold, though, maybe.
Well, there's two colds. So far, cold and open are the most popular answers. So so far, you guys have got a lot of points. But Russ and Missy might break that. What'd you guys go with?
I'm still looking for the CRISPR, but...
Empty! So empty is the most popular answer, it turns out. And cold is the match. So that means, what is that, a point for the Grays? Nothing for the...
Everybody gets the point.
Everybody gets 1 point. All right, good job. All right, next one, here we go. Ready? Dumb Dora is so dumb...
How dumb is she?
That when she wanted a bouncing baby, she made love to her husband on a blank. Dumb Dora is so dumb that when she wanted a bouncing baby, she made love to her husband on a blank. I'm gonna check the chat. Wait a minute. Someone in the chat says you guys won Willamette Week's Portland's Best Couple 4 years in a row.
Yeah, our listeners are messing with you right now.
That is our idiot friend. Please ignore him.
No, all right. Yeah, go ahead and chime in, Boba Fett, whatever you got to say. All right.
It's too late. The rumors have started.
Well, Willamette Week is nothing to start rumors about, you guys. We take that very seriously. All right. So everybody's answer is down. Steve, Dumb Dora is so dumb that when she wanted a bouncing baby, she made love to her husband on a blank. What'd you say?
On a trampoline.
Trampoline, of course. That'll make your baby bounce. All right. So we're looking for trampoline. Clofton and Katie, what did you say?
Trampoline.
Trampoline. Very nice. Is that your cat in between you?
Is that our cat? Like, we don't have seven.
Well, I can only see one of them. Is that... I don't know if that was a cat or the turkey you're making for Thanksgiving.
Wasn't somebody just talking about helping people that hoard cats?
Seven. Seven isn't a lot, but they live in a storage container, so it's a little crowded. All right. Natalie and David, we're looking for trampoline. What'd you guys say?
Pogo stick.
Pogo stick, yes. Hard to do, but definitely worth it.
Ow, ow, ow.
Right? Ouch.
Ow.
That's the kids. That's what the kids are into. Ed and Clee, we're looking for trimampoline. What did you say? You also said trimampoline. Good job. All right, there's a point, and that's now the most popular answer. Greg and Sarah, the Nibbler family. What did you guys say?
Trimampoline.
Trimampoline. Good job. That's a point. So you guys now all have 3 points because that's the most popular answer. Anastasia and Austin, what'd you guys go with?
Trampoline, but did I spell it right?
Looks weird, right?
Yeah, it
every
does.
Time I'm looking at it, I'm like, did I spell that okay?
And my dyslexia is going crazy with this word for some reason.
Also, you're clearly super high, so that doesn't help. All right. last but not least, Missy and Russell, what did you guys go with?
We also went with
trampoline. So everyone said trampoline except the Bax Schaefers, is that correct?
That is correct.
Wow, all right. So that's 3 points for everyone except Natalie and David. All right. Well, we know how this is going to go. Okay. Next question. Hey, Steve, I heard you vacationed in Tucson a while ago. Did you find anything to do besides blank? Hey, Steve, I heard that you vacationed in Tucson a while ago. Did you find anything to do besides blank? FYI, I grew up in Tucson. So, hey, what's that cat's name?
Peachy.
Okay. Anytime your pet appears on screen, we need an introduction. The kids at home love to see that. They love to see the aminals. All right, everybody got their answer down? Oh, did I pronounce Willamette wrong? That's how they say it in Illinois, okay. Willamette. All right, so Steve, I heard you vacationed in Tucson a while ago. Did you find anything to do besides?
Besides sweat?
No, besides sweat. All right. Sweat is what we're looking for. So he went to Tucson and he just sweated. So we're looking for sweat. Katie and Clofton, did you find anything to do besides?
It's like the second thing. Meth.
Meth. Oh, he did that. Don't worry about it. He did plenty of meth. Oh, he's got meth money. All right. Natalie and David, what did you guys go with?
So I actually like Tucson, but we had... leave.
Do you find anything to do besides leave? That is the best part of visiting Tucson at the end. All right, now good answer, but no match. Ed and Clee, you have relatives here in Arizona, right?
Yeah, but only in Yuma, and I don't know anything about Arizona besides that Yuma is boring.
So what did you say?
Responsibility for this answer.
We just said Yuma.
Well, you guys have got Steve pegged because he loves to dune buggy. Oh my God!
Not as much as I love to leave Tucson.
fair. All right, still not a match. Sarah and Greg, we're looking for sweat. What did you guys say?
This is a very Arizona category. I feel like we're in the Northwest where it's cloudy and rainy and full of serial killers, so we just put lay in the sun.
Lay in the sun, sure.
Like to be doing, and clearly
not there.
Close to sweat.
That didn't work out.
Sometimes it will lead to sweating, but so far no most popular answers, just least popular. Anastasia and Austin, what'd you guys say?
Burn.
Burn. Also, something that happens when you're sweating and burning and all that stuff. Look at Peachy. What is he doing?
No, this is Vinny.
Oh, that's Vinny now. All right.
Yeah.
Racist.
All white cats look alike to me. All right. Still no matches. Missy and Russ, last chance. What do you think? What'd you guys do in Tucson? Meth. Oh, that's a match. Excellent. Let me give you a ding-a-ling for that. There you go. All right. So,
is that like a submarine sandwich versus a Euro? It's the same thing, just different regional.
So, who else said meth?
We did.
Who? The Grays. Okay, so the Gray family and the Mionkeys both said meth, so they both get a point because that's the most popular answer. All right. Here I got another one about Steve. Here we go. Hey, Steve, I don't know if I should be offended or not, but I found out that the only comics who didn't perform at Joe Gangemi's party were me, you, and blank. I don't know if I should be offended or not, but I found out the only comics who didn't perform at Joe Gangemi's party over the summer was me, you, and blank. This one's wide open.
Two inside baseball on this one.
Well, this one's left over from the summer also. It had just happened back when I wrote it. All right. So, yeah, Joe Gangemi had a party and he did a comedy show. And the only people who didn't perform were me, you, and who else, Steve?
Gallagher 2.
Gallagher 2! They couldn't even get Gallagher 1.
They couldn't get Gallagher 1.
It was too small a crowd. All right, so we're going. Gallagher 2 is what we're trying to match. Clifton and Katie, what did you guys say? It was me, Steve, and who else?
There's a cat.
Vinny, watch out, buddy.
Me, Steve, and Vinny.
What's up?
Vinny actually did that show. He killed it.
Pete Grudge.
Ah, Clopton Pete Grudge was not invited.
Ribs.
All right. He couldn't. He was hospitalized for a broken grundle. All right. David and Natalie, what did you guys say? We're looking for Gallagher 2.
Somebody is.
What did you say? Richard Cheney. Whoa. too soon, guys. Come on.
It's 15.
Wow.
It's not too soon.
Come on. I was just watching Platypus Man, you guys. Not cool. All right. Ed and Klee.
Nice pull.
Thank you. Ed and Klee, what do you say? We're looking for Gallagher 2?
I don't know if I spelled it right, but we said Joe and Jenny.
He's been banned from his own backyard comedy show. all right. Greg and Sarah, the only people who didn't perform at the show were me, Steve, and who else?
I'm gonna go with Andy Dick.
Andy Dick. I don't know if you guys follow him on Twitter, but did you see he posted that he's giving all his stuff away? He's moving out of LA.
Oh, that's never a good
yeah,
thing.
Yeah, right. You don't, and also, who wants Andy Dick's stuff?
I have a simple solution to this problem. Andy Dick needs someone to look over him. Britney Spears' father is not part of the conservatorship. They're the perfect couple.
I'm a big fan.
Watch that reality show.
I would watch.
100%.
I'm a fan. All right, so far no matches. Great answers, but no matches. Anastasia, Austin, did you guys say Gallagher 2?
No.
Which Gallagher did you say? Neither one, huh? David Spade. Oh, too soon. Come on, guys. Really? Oh, man. Wow, what a bummer. Pour one out for D. Spade. All right, last chance for a match. Russ, Missy, what'd you go with?
Die.
The Andy Dick, Britney Spears' dad show would be called Dick Speared.
That is solid.
Sure.
Bill, unless you're hired.
Already booked.
Who'd you go with? Bill Cosby. It was already. All right. Well, I was hoping for answers like that, so at least I got a Bill Cosby out of it. No one said Louis C.K. All right. Oh, Steve, you got a critique here. Someone's saying your mic is really soft. But that's a change for you, so that's nice. Something else is soft. All right. No matches. Here we go. Last question. Ready? I started going to a new Catholic church in my neighborhood, but it's only because they use a blank for the Eucharist. All right. I've started going to a new Catholic church in my neighborhood, but it's only because they use a blank for the Eucharist. This one's wide open. So many things that you could say here. Hopefully Steve will say the funniest answer. Everybody got their answers written down? All right. We good? Here we go. Steve, I went to this new Catholic church. I loved it. But I only went because they use a blank for the Eucharist.
I didn't know what any of those words meant, so I just wrote soft mic.
A soft mic, sure. The Eucharist is like the wafer they give you to eat. So you could have said Twinkie Ding Dong, but soft mic, sure. I'll go to a place that has a soft mic for the Eucharist. Who? Okay, Katie and Clifton, who's this now?
This is Butt Butts.
My favorite.
Name Lady Bella Buttingsworth.
Butt Butts, gorgeous. All right, so Steve said soft mic. That's the answer we're looking for. What did you guys say?
Panic answer. We said beans on toast.
Beans on toast. That would be good. That's like a Liverpool, a church in Liverpool.
Episcopalians.
All right. No match. Natalie, David, I know you're good practicing Catholics. What did you guys say?
So I'm Jewish, but David helped me come up with
an acid tab. Hell yes. That is a church. All right. No matches there. Ed and Clee, I know you're very religious. What'd you guys say?
I'll take credit for this one. Potato chip.
Yeah, see? There. Now you're going in my mind. You're thinking like I think. Hell yes. I went to a place.
You can't have just one Eucharist.
I went to a place once. They had a big ass scone. It was delicious.
Gluten free.
All right. So far, still no matches. Anastasia and Austin, what'd you guys say?
Hoagie or altar boy?
They use an altar boy as the Eucharist. Why not? Lean into it, right? That's what I say. I mean, we all know that's what the Catholic Church is all about. Fuck, why pretend? Everybody gets their own altar boy. Hell yes. All right, Missy and Russ, last chance for a match.
Well, I figure if you're going to serve a cracker as the body of Christ, it should have a hole in it. So I went with Cheez-It.
Delicious. Yes. But like you grab a whole handful of Christ, though. You'd have to, right? They're so delicious.
The toasty flavor of Eucharist.
Oh, do you got the spicy Christ? Do you guys have that Tabasco Christ? Those are better. Or the big ones? Yeah, the big Jesus.
I like the white cheddar flesh of the Lord.
All right. That's the end of the match game round.
Paul, you forgot about us, bud.
Who? Oh, did I skip you guys? Oh, I'm sorry.
I mean, you didn't get it right, but you forgot
What'd you guys say? What'd you say? What was your answer?
We read the room wrong.
Grandol. Now, that's a good answer. I wish someone else had said it. All right. Anyone else I forgot? Good. Okay, so let's go ahead and recap the scores, Steve, and see how everybody did so far.
We have Katie and Clofton in the lead with 8 points.
Oh.
Followed by Russ and Missy with 6 points. A tie, Clee and Ed, and Greg and Sarah have 5 each.
Good job.
Anastasia and Austin have 4, and David and Natalie have 2.
All right, so it's still anybody's games, but you guys know...
You guys right where we want you.
You know what you got to do next. Let's move on to everybody's favorite round. Next is our hashtag wars. There it is. We move on to the hashtag wars. You know how we play hashtag wars. Yesterday, I gave all the teams a hashtag and told them to come up with as many funny responses as they could to that particular hashtag. Oh, wait. I threw it away. Where'd it go? So we're going to go around and we'll see what they wrote. If it's funny, you get a point. If it's not funny, no points. It's that easy. Okay, so we went with one letter off Thanksgiving food or one letter off holiday food. Either one of those works. Examples would be sweat potatoes or creamed porn or reamed corn. Either one. Creamed porn or reamed corn. They're both are appropriate. All right, so we get it. We understand how this works. Steve, you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, Katie and Clifton, knock us out. What's your first one?
Green bean acerole.
Dynamite. Way to start it off. Natalie and David?
Wishboner.
Yeah, that works. Just add an R. I like it. Ed and Clee?
Our first selection is sweet potato pipe.
Nice. I'm not sure what that means, but okay. Hey, who wants to see my sweet potato pipe? Sarah and Greg, what do you say?
I don't know what it means.
Our first one's going to be butter milk pancakes.
Mmm, delicious. Biscuits, I love waking
biscuits,
up.
Excuse me, biscuits.
Oh, okay, either one. I like it. Anastasia and Austin, what do you got? Oh, there goes. Oh, there she is.
Torn on the Cob.
Torn on the Cob. Things got a little rough. Okay.
Yeah.
Missy and Russ, what do you got for us?
I got Manberry Sauce.
Oh, not okay.
It's two letters, though.
Yeah, that's two letters. Yes. David wants to point out that you replaced two letters. Okay. All right. I like it, though. Katie and Clifton, what's your next one?
Hot butted rolls.
Hot butted rolls. Anything with the word butt in it, I'm a fan. You know that. David and Natalie?
Honey baked harm.
Honey baked harm. Oh, yeah. I think he means a honey baked harm, right? From Princess Bride. Okay, Ed and Clee, you got one?
Pumpkin pie.
Nice. Yeah. Well, it would be Cumpkin. Yeah, Cumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Ew.
Yeah, people say pumpkin pie.
Oh, okay. So Cumpkin. Yeah, I guess that's okay. It's a regional thing. Greg and Sarah, what do you got?
We're going to go with, follow that up with pumpkin pea.
Pumpkin pea, certainly. Yes. Nice. Anastasia, Austin?
Cream scorn.
Oh, cream scorn. Nice. I like, we got three corn ones. Excellent. Missy and Russ.
This is a protein alternative for the orphans. Turnkey.
Turnkey. Nice. All right. Okay, let's go ahead and read them all off. Katie, Clifton, just fucking machine gun them. Give us all your best ones. Knock us out.
Oh, Russell's Sprouts.
Sure.
Butternut Squish.
Nice. I like that one.
Corn Breed. And Deviled Egos.
Deviled Egos. Oh, man.
That's where I stopped.
All right. That's good stuff. Excellent work. All right. David and Natalie, I know this is your favorite part of the game.
Yeah, this is the best part. We got a bunch. If you're gonna be drinking, if you're gonna be eating turkey, you're gonna want to make sure to pair that with a white wife.
A white wife, sure. A glass of white wife goes well. Yeah, excellent.
You don't want the balls.
Wait, I missed it. Say it again.
You don't want to fill up on dinner trolls.
Oh, okay. No, absolutely not. Too many crabs.
This one's more popular in certain parts of the country, but MAGA-roni and cheese.
Nice. That's very good, MAGA.
And also, don't forget the ingredient in turkey that makes Elon Musk sleepy, crypto fan.
He replaced it with a C, with a T, with a C. All right. Nice.
And then to finish, pie a la mold.
Pie a la mold, sure.
Yeah.
Delicious.
And we got candy jacks. We got butler balls.
And finally, pumpkin pig.
Pumpkin pig and a butler ball turkey. Delicious. All right. Oh, good stuff. Okay, Ed and Clee, the bar is very high. What do you got for us?
Go through the whole list. Okay. Some of these. Okay. also popular in other parts of the country is a. Clan DDM.
Sure.
So we had also candied prams.
Oh, okay.
That's pretty terrible. Also a mat and cheese, just like a yoga mat with cheese.
Sure.
Roasted parrots instead of roasted carrots, you see.
Oh!
Parrots, you see. not defeathered either, Anastasia. No defeathering. You
know, oh my God. Just roasted with everything.
And then after that, you can sprinkle it on your ashed potatoes because they burnt up those parrots.
Ashed potatoes, sure.
Yeah, in the end, there's just, you know, I think we shot our wad with pumpkin pie on
this. Well, that's good. It's good that you led with it. That's good. Because sometimes Sometimes people will snipe it from you. All right. There's someone in the chat said Greg and Sarah got this, so they're expecting a lot from you guys. That's
what?
North Dog. North Dog said you guys got this.
So oh, boy.
They're expecting
oh, wait,
a lot.
Does that mean we're going?
Go. Your turn.
Okay. All right. So we have crap berry sauce.
Crap berry sauce, sure.
Dork meat.
Yeah. I like it.
Candied yams.
Okay.
Molested yams, clearly. Lice cream.
Yeah, sure. Lice cream.
And then my personal favorite, mashed potatoes.
You get two big scoops. Nice. All right. That's good stuff. I love it. All right. Anastasia and Austin, what do you guys got for us?
I got mashed potatoes.
Hose with an H, sure.
Yeah, with an H. Pecan lie. Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Yeah. Cowan bread. Gravy.
Yes.
Uh huh.
I had green bean casserole too, but we can't.
Got snaked.
Whatever. Dinner toll.
Dinner toll. You gotta pay the dinner toll before we can eat.
Pay the dinner. Staffing, strong beans, staff dressing, mashed titty toes. Poached cobbler.
Poached cobbler. All right. That works. So I'm waiting for one. No one has said it yet. Missy and Russ, you're last. Send us home.
Oh. This is going to be anticlimactic, then, I can assure you. So I have candied yaks. I think you get pumpkin pie when you're pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie, nice. I like that.
And, not food for that. You could always just corn on my knob. You got a Jolly Green Giant's frozen pea.
Sure.
And finally, I can believe it's not butter.
All right. Because it's not. It's like marbles. It's not even food. All right. That's good stuff. Nobody said deviled legs. I want deviled legs. L-E-G-G-S.
Did we have that?
Well, L-E-G...
Have
like,
deviled eggs for Thanksgiving?
Yeah.
Well, it's a white people thing. It's a white people thing.
Oh, I was like, who has deviled eggs for Thanksgiving?
White people.
Definitely not black folks.
Yeah, well, also, if you like deviled eggs, you want any excuse to eat deviled eggs anyways, so...
Yeah.
So, yeah. I'm not a fan, personally.
Deviled eggs for every holiday.
I do like deviled legs, though. The pantyhose is what I'm talking about. All right. We got some good scores on that one. I know that definitely things have changed. Steve, what are the scores so far?
Looks like Anastasia and Austin are in the lead at 16.
Ooh.
We have Kree and Ed, Greg and Sarah, and Katie and Clofton all have 13 each.
Oh, my goodness.
David and Natalie and Russ and Missy have 12 each.
All right. Wow, it's a close game, but Anastasia and Austin are still in first place. Clearly, they're making it work by not living together. So good job, you guys. Let's go ahead and move on to our next game up, which is, where's the theme to that? Here it is. Yes, we're going to play Name That Tune. That's our favorite game. So, but the way Name That Tune starts is I'm going to play a game. I'm going to play a song, and then you just have to buzz in and tell me what the name of the song is. So I'm going to send you guys some information about the buzz-in. But while we're doing that, Steve, I understand we have a new sponsor for the show. Is that right?
Yes, we do.
Okay, tell people all about it.
The holiday season is upon us, but don't panic if you haven't found the perfect gift for the Tom Hanks fan in your life. Instead, come on down to T. Hanks Giving, the world's largest emporium of memorabilia for the world's greatest actor. We have the widest range of bloody volleyballs, bottles of vanilla extract, and single red shoes this side of the Mississippi. Yeah. Act now, and every order over $50 will receive a free CD by rap impresario Chet Hayes, the son that Tom doesn't talk about. That's T. Hanks Giving. Call now. Operators are standing by. Ask us about our terminal-themed escape room.
There, I like the vanilla extract reference. Very nice. Talk about a deep pull. Okay, so in the chat there, I have put a website for you guys to go to, Buzzin Live. Go to Buzzin Live on your phone or whatever, and then put in that code that I put in the Zoom chat. I got one, two, I got four teams so far, waiting on two more teams. While you're doing that, like I said, the way Name That Tune works is I'm going to play a song, and the first person to, yeah, feel free to play with your buzzers. The first person to buzz in with the correct answer will get a point. It's that easy. So let's see. Schaefer Bax, Russ and Missy. One, two, three, four. Okay, I think I got everybody. Okay.
No.
Wait, are we, is it just,
no.
I'm asking a question so you can make fun of me. Is it just one of us from our team or both people?
Whatever you want to do, however many devices you have. But it really, it won't make that much of a difference. Okay, so I got, is that everybody?
No, you're still waiting on me.
Okay.
Trying to get in.
You want a buzz?
Yeah, Austin.
Sorry,
and
Paul, song and artist? Is that?
No, we're just going to be going with song. The way it works is I will play the song, and then you buzz in with the name of the song. And then if you can tell me who's singing the song, I'll give you a bonus point. All right? Now, these first songs are all sung by SNL cast members. So there's a hint, all right? These are all very popular, well-known songs, but they're not sung by the original artist. They're sung by SNL cast members. So like I said, buzz in when you know the name of the song. If you get it right, you get a point. And then if you can tell me who's singing it, I'll give you a bonus point. All right? Is that everybody? Excellent. Okay, here we go. Name this tune.
Every breath you take, every move.
All right, that seemed pretty easy. Russ and Missy, you're first. What's that song?
Oh, is the name of the...
Is it Every Breath You Take?
Yes, it's Every Breath You Take is the name of that song. Very good. Okay, give a listen, Russ and Missy. Tell me if you know who's singing it.
Oh. Every bond you break, every step you take, I'll be watching you.
Every single day. Wow. Okay. Which SNL cast member was that?
Jimmy Fallon?
Jimmy
Fallon?
It was not. Anybody have a guess?
Victoria Jackson.
It was Robert Downey Jr. That was Robert Downey Jr.
Oh, I knew it.
Wow.
Well,
then you should have fucking buzzed.
From an episode of Ally McBeal. All right, so that's 1 point for the Meowkies. Here we go. Buzzers reset. Name this tune.
That's what they say when we're together. And watch how you play.
Oh, once again, that's Russ and Missy first. What is that song?
I think
was it us? Oh, shit.
Russ and Missy.
I Think We're Alone Now.
There you go. It's I Think We're Alone Now. Do you know who's singing it?
Gilbert all the way.
Who is it?
Gilbert.
Yes, of course, it's Gilbert Gottfried doing that song on his podcast. Very good. All right, that's 2 points for Russ and Missy. They're running away with this round. Here we go, buzzers reset. Name this tune. Again, that's Russ and Missy. What is the name of that song?
Endless Love.
It is Endless Love. Well done. Who's singing it? Who is it?
Is it Adam Sandler and from the movie? From that movie?
I don't know. Can you play it again?
Is that your guess, Adam Sandler?
No, not yet.
It's two people from SNL. Just give me one of them if you know it.
Can I take a guess?
No,
Will Ferrell. Will Holly Shannon?
No, it's not. It's Jimmy Fallon and Tina Fey.
Oh, I was close.
Yep, you were very close. All right, buzzers reset. You guys get in here. Name this tune.
I could feel at the time there was no way of knowing fallen leaves.
Oh, there you go. Natalie and David. That one was made for you. What's that song?
It's More Than This.
And who's singing it?
Yeah.
Kevin Nealon.
No, who is it, guys? It's Bill Murray from Lost in Translation. That's a movie. I don't know if you guys have seen that, but it's a really good movie, David. You should check it out sometime.
He's all right. Only seen it in Swedish.
Bill Murray
Let me write it down.
Bill, wait a minute. You're drinking. You're not writing. All right. I get the feeling you were being sarcastic, but all right. Buzzers reset. Here we go. Name this tune.
Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth.
Oh, that's Buttman 42069 first. What's that song, Buttman?
Hallelujah.
And who is the singer?
Kate McKinnon.
That's right. It's Kate McKinnon doing her impression of Hillary Clinton on SNL. Very good. So that's 2 points for the Grudge family. All right, now I'm going to make it a little harder. We're going to keep going, but these next songs are mashups, all right? Forget about the SNL thing. These are two songs mashed up together. So when you buzz in, you need to tell me both songs, all right? So don't buzz in unless you know both songs, okay? Here's your first mashup. Name these tunes. That's it. Nobody?
I don't have the buzzer, so I would buzz.
Okay. Go ahead, Anastasia.
I just buzzed in.
Anastasia raised her hand already. Go ahead.
No, yeah, you're right.
What is it, Anastasia?
It's Walk This Way and I Can't Get Next to You.
There you go. Walk This Way by the Run DMCs and Can't Get Next to You by the Temps, I think. All right. Good job. That's 1 point for A&A, Team A&A. All right. Buzzers reset.
The second one?
Name these tunes.
Let the bodies hit the floor.
All right, that's Clea and Ed first. What are those songs, Clea and Ed?
Really?
Hey Ya and Let the Bodies Hit the Floor.
There you go.
My buzzer's broke.
Yeah, blame your fucking buzzer. All right. Good job. All right, so that's a point for Clea and Ed. Here we go. Buzzers reset. Man, get rid of this fool. Okay, buzzers reset. Name these tunes.
She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead.
That's Buttman first. What are those songs, Buttman?
Again.
All-Star and the theme from The Office?
That's what it is.
Oh,
yeah, we are not doing it.
I know.
That's my new podcast. I watch episodes of The Office and I compare it with different songs by Smash Mouth and I compare and contrast it. It's called The One Where Nobody Listens. All right. all right. Buzzers reset. Good job, Clofton and Katie. Here we go. Name these tunes.
In West Philadelphia, born and raised on the playground is where I spent most.
That's Clea and Ed. What are those songs?
I Want You Back and The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Hell yes it is. I Want You Back by Jackson and the Fives. And of course, William R. Smith.
So we're up to no good.
So fucking good. All right.
You were playing on that Mumford Sons meet Silver Surfer shit earlier. Like, this is culturally insensitive. You done brought it back.
So. I tried to mix it up a little bit. You'll like this next one. All right, this is the jam for sure. Ready? Buzzers reset. Name these tunes.
This is a story all about how my wife got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute.
All right, that's Russ and Missy first. Back on. What are those songs, guys?
The Fresh Prince. And
he pushed it before I said. I didn't know.
Okay. Fresh Prince and?
How does it go?
Austin and Anastasia, you buzzed in second. What is it?
Okay.
If you want to be my lover and Fresh Prince.
There you go. It's Fresh Prince and Wannabe.
Fuck yeah.
Oh, hell yes.
Get with me, better make it fast.
That's a great fucking song.
More culturally insensitive than previous.
But... I'm just insensitive in general. All right. That is the end of the Name That Tune round. Steve, let's see how it all shook out. Hold on, let me grab a pen first. All right, Steve, how did it all shake out? What's the placing?
Hold on, mathing.
Oh, that's your favorite, isn't it? Mathed potatoes.
Math. I quit. Anastasia and Austin are in the lead with 18 points.
Woo!
We have a tie for second place. Russ and Misty and Katie and Crofton both have 16 each. Following that is P and Ed with 15. And then the teams of David, Natalie, and Greg and Sarah both have 13 each.
All right, so as we saw, Anastasia and Austin jumped into first place, and everybody else is kind of tied. So that's how the placing goes as we move into our next round. Where is it? Who wants to beat a geek? That's what we're calling it. This is what we've done before the show. I asked each one of the teams to give me one piece of pop culture or just one piece of one field of trivia that they said they were experts in. So Steve and I have come up with very difficult questions based on the topics they gave us. So one by one, we'll go around by the teams and we'll see how you did. We'll ask you a question. We'll see how you do. If you get it, you move on to the next round. If not, you're eliminated. All right. So first... in first place is Anastasia and Austin. Because they're in first place, they get to answer the challenge first. So we will first go to Katie and Clofton. Since you're in second place, your question is about Chopped, the TV show Chopped. You guys said you were experts in the TV show Chopped. So Anastasia and Austin, because you're in first place, you get to choose. Would you like to answer this question about the TV show Chopped? Or would you like Katie and Clofton to answer it? Keeping in mind, if they get it right, they move on. If you get it right, you have to wait and come back around. You do get a second chance because you're in first place. But how do you feel about the topic of Chopped? Anastasia, who is that?
Oh, that is Zora Neale Hurston. She's done.
Okay, bye. She just showed up for a brief moment. Yeah. All right, what do you guys think? You're going to go with the Chopped question, or do you want to let the Grays handle it?
Let them...
All right. When I say the Grays, I mean aliens who are coming to abduct me, by the way. All right.
Okay, cool. Even better.
All right. So, Katie and Clofton, you get to answer this question about the TV show Chopped. If you answer correctly, you move on. If not, you're eliminated for good. Are you ready?
We're ready.
Let's play. Here's your question. What is the name of the late night spinoff series which premiered in 2015? Once again, what is the name of the late-night spin-off series of Chopped, which premiered in 2015? What do you think?
Chopped After Hours.
You say Chopped After Hours. Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
Chopped After Hours is your final answer? The correct answer is, in fact... Chopped After Hours! Well done! All right, so you guys are still in it. Now, Anastasia and Austin will come back around. You do get a second chance because you guys are in first place. So just stay frosty. Katie and Clifton, congratulations. You moved on to the next round. Next is Russ and Missy. They were tied with you. They said they were an expert in all things monkeys. Clearly, Missy is deferring to Russ in this case. But by all things monkeys, that means the TV show, movies, personal information, everything. So, Katie and Clifton, you guys decide. Do you want to answer this monkeys question, or do you want to defer to Russ and Missy, keeping in mind if they get it right, you are eliminated for good? What do you want to do?
I don't know anything about the monkeys.
I don't know either, but we have to try. They, you know what? Send it their way.
All right, they're gonna send it on to Russ and Missy. You guys ready?
I guess.
Here's your question about the monkeys. Who is credited on the album cover for compiling the soundtrack to the motion picture Head?
Who is credited on the album cover, the front of the album?
Who is credited on the album cover? Well, I guess it could be back cover as well. But who is credited for compiling the soundtrack to the motion picture Head?
Compiling the soundtrack? Well, because the cover, the foil, it says Head, and it says monkeys all around the edge. On the back, in either the lower left or right corner, block that is sometimes produced by or something, the monkey.
You have any idea?
I feel like in my gut it is the group name of the monkey. The thing is it that?
It's all on you, obviously, Russ. What do you think?
I'm just going to say the monkeys.
Okay, so your final answer is the monkeys. Is that correct?
I mean, silly as it sounds, I'm going to say that for compiling the soundtrack, you're saying?
Yep.
Compiling the
soundtrack. Actually written on the actual album?
Yes, he gets credit on the album for compiling the soundtrack. Oh, I just told you it was a
he
dude.
Gets credit? Oh, did you say he? You yeah. said he gets credit?
Yeah.
Oh, no. That changes everything.
Well, yeah, slightly. What do you say?
No, it's not. Compiling.
Yeah, Greg has left.
I'll say
he quit.
Sure, I'll say sure.
Who are you going to say? I'm sorry. Peter Tork?
Peter Tork? No, Victor Mature.
Oh, Victor Mature.
Victor Mature.
All right, Russ, I need an answer.
I'm going to say it says the monkeys.
Okay.
I feel like that's not.
So the monkeys is your final answer, correct?
Yeah.
The answer is Jack Nicholson.
What?
Jack Nicholson, who also appears in the film, and has
helped write the film.
Helped write the script. He also worked. Didn't he also work on Tommy? I think he also worked on the soundtrack for Tommy as well. But anyways, that you guys got that wrong. Sorry, Missy and Russ, you've been eliminated. Give them a hand. They did a great job. So that means Katie and Clofton, good job. You guys are still in it. You're still alive. Moving on in third place. Klee and Ed are in third place. They said they were experts in Star Trek Voyager. Star Trek Voyager. So again, Katie and Clopton, you have to decide. Do you want to answer this question about Voyager? Or do you want to push it on to Klee and Ed? Yeah, are you going to move it forward?
Because good Lord, we have no idea.
All right. So, all right, guys, it's up to you, Ed and Klee.
All right, smarty.
Here is your question. If you get it right, you move on and you've eliminated Clofton and Katie. If not, they move on to the next round. You ready? Here's your question, yes. Klee and Ed. What is the name of Star Trek Voyager's mother? No, I'm just kidding. That's not the question. All right, here's the...
How did the ship meet her?
That's my new podcast. I compare Voyager and How I Met Your Mother. All right, here's the real question. I think it's easy. What species was Kes a member of? It's that simple. What species O'Compan. Was Kes a member of? What'd you say?
O'Compan.
You say O'Compan?
O'Compa.
Is that your final answer?
O'Compa, yeah.
O'Compa is your final answer. Kes, who eventually ascended and was off the show, She was, in fact, a member of the Ocampan race. Well done, Cleoned. I told you it was easy. So she is an Ocampan. Well done. You guys move on. Katie and Clifton, I'm sorry. You've been eliminated. Give them a hand. All right, who's next? David and Natalie. Now, you guys said
Did
you were...
forget her name?
Yes. I almost right said there. I almost said David and wife. David and wife.
White wife.
White wife. Yo, you guys said you were expert.
Football players?
You said you were expert on Mystery Diners. The aforementioned
Food Network program Mystery Diners.
Mystery Diners.
Show, I love it.
All right. It's very popular. It's so terrible. Cleoned, this is your choice now. You get to choose. Do you want to answer this question about Mystery Diners, or would you like Natalie and David to answer it? Keeping in mind that if they answer it, you're eliminated. And if not, you guys move on one step closer to winning the game. What do you want to do?
Can I have a follow-up question? Mm-hmm. Mystery Diners as in a concept or some sort of show about...
It's
a Food Network reality program.
I describe a diner that I would like to go to sometime in my life, and they have to tell me why it wouldn't work as a business.
You order a cup of coffee, they hit you with a nut
sauce. It's called Cup of Nuts. What do you think, guys? What are you going to do?
We cannot answer a question about a specific show about Mystery Diners. Thusly, we will be passing that on.
All right. Natalie and David, it's up to you. If you can answer this Mystery Diners question correctly, you move on and they're eliminated. You ready?
Yes.
Here we go. In the first episode of Mystery Diners, Rob the bartender was fired from what well-known Los Angeles establishment. Any fan
Maeve's Residuals.
You say it was Maeve's Residuals. Is that your final answer?
Maeve's Residuals, yes.
Maeve's Residuals is their final answer. And that is correct. Well done. Studio City mainstay, Maeve's Residuals. Anyone who's watched the show should know that. How many times have you been to Residuals, David?
Many.
Natalie's
probably a dozen.
She's a veteran.
Yeah, you go there a lot. What old TV actors have you seen there in your visits?
Really, no one.
Really? Because I used to drive for Lyft, I used to pick up Barry Corbin there a lot. We all know Barry Corbin from the movie War Games. I used to pick because he didn't live in LA.
For old men.
Of course. But when I picked him up, the first time the car broke down and I was like, I don't know what to do. And he goes, hell, I'd piss on a spark plug if it'll help. No, that didn't really happen. But that's his line from War Games. But the second time I picked him up, I told him that story and he laughed like a fucking, he thought it was the funniest thing he'd ever heard. He's a very nice man. All right. So you guys got that right. Obviously, Residuals is the correct answer. Sorry, Ed and Klee. That means you've been eliminated. Give him a hand, everybody. Good job, you guys. You made it so close. Let's see.
Can I just say to the ladies out there, don't let some man prescribe to you your limitations because she did know that answer.
Really?
I presumed that we didn't, and I've ruined everything.
So
I have to go to sleep with that tonight.
Oh,
I have
wow.
to be in that for the next few hours, and it's going to be pleasant. So I'm truly...
Hey, this is what you do a podcast about, Ed. This right here. This is the fucking...
Into a roasting session.
This is the fucking podcast. What was Ed wrong about this week? That's the name of the fucking show.
Oh, so
I would listen
things.
The shit out of
Every
that.
Every week there'd be something new.
That's what I'm saying.
All right, bye.
Years and years on the air. All right. I guess we're down to one more before we go back around to first place. Sarah and Greg... who were in last place, or tied for last place.
Thanks for that.
Sure. They said they were experts in the TV show Seinfeld. So, Natalie and David, I know you guys like TV. You're probably planning a podcast where you compare Seinfeld and the Platypus Man every episode. But you have to decide. Do you want to answer this Seinfeld question, or do you want Natalie and Greg to answer it? I mean, you're Natalie. Do you want Sarah and Greg to answer?
Natalie.
Sorry.
We're mixing it up here.
Hi, I'm Sarah.
All the white women. I can't keep all these white women safe. Or straight.
We're going to take it.
Fucking thing.
No.
All right, hat was bugging me.
The worst
the worst ones to be messed up with for this. This is
yeah, it's pretty bad. So what are you guys gonna do, back Schaefer's?
We're gonna take it.
All right. So if you guys answer this correct, you move on. You're one question away from winning. If not, Greg and Sarah move on without doing any work whatsoever. You ready? Here we go. Here is your question about Seinfeld, Natalie and David. On what date is Festivus traditionally celebrated? On what date is Festivus traditionally celebrated?
Now, is this Western Festivus or Eastern Orthodox?
I'm old school, man. All right, guys, what do you say?
We're going to guess Boxing Day, December 26th.
So you say it's December 26th is the day that Festivus is usually celebrated. Is that your final answer?
Yeah. Yeah.
They say December 26th is their final answer. The correct answer is, in fact, December 23rd. Did you guys know that one? Greg, Sarah?
I would have guessed that, but yes.
There you go. Well done.
23rd, 26th.
So, well, many times the guess is because you know it in your subconscious. So, well done. That means Natalie and David, sorry, you've been eliminated. You came very close, but you have been eliminated. Thanks for playing. So now we're back around.
You're still sending us the cranberry sauce and the Aquaman, right?
Oh, I'm sending you some stuff. I'm sending you some stuff. Oh, you're... You're definitely gonna get some stuff.
Goddamn groats!
All right,
give us all groats.
So we're back around. Anastasia and Austin, they said they were experts in horror movies. Although this was back when Alice was on the team. I gotta be honest with you, Anastasia. The only reason I booked you was so I could get your mom. And I'm super pissed that she didn't show.
I know. And the stories that she could have told about the monkeys.
Right?
You know, she used to dance for them.
She used to dance for the monkeys?
Yeah, she used to dance for the monkeys.
See? That's why I like having...
that out loud. It's weird.
Ooh, nice. Right. Oh, yeah. Well, we'll have her on again sometime, hopefully, when she's off the set. Yeah. All right, so you guys said you were expert in horror movies. So, Sarah, Greg, this is your chance. Do you want to answer this horror movie question, or do you want Anastasia and Austin? Keep in mind, whoever gets this last question right is the winner of the game. What are you guys going to do?
I mean, shoot.
We're gonna go for it.
Let's go down in flames, Greg. Let's do this.
Excellent. All right, so they're gonna go ahead and try to answer it. If they get it right, they're the winners. If not, Anastasia and Austin win by doing absolutely nothing, just by coming in first place. So they can just sit back. They don't even have to answer. Although I have a feeling I have a feeling Anastasia knows this one. So you guys probably chose wisely by trying to answer it yourself. Yeah, Austin, kick back. Why don't you go ahead and put on something comfortable, Austin? Just relax. All right. You guys ready?
Look here, Austin. Wakanda forever.
I don't know what that means. All right, here we go. Here's your question, Greg and Sarah, about horror movies. What was a 1953 horror film that was remade in 2005 with Paris Hilton in the lead role? What was a 1953 horror film remade in 2005 with Paris Hilton in the lead role?
I got this.
Okay.
What is Wax Museum?
All right, this is not Jeopardy, but you you say the answer is Wax Museum. Is that your
Wax
final
Museum?
Is that your final answer?
That is my final answer.
All right, if the answer is Wax Museum, you guys are the winners. If not, Anastasia and Austin, they go home with the trophy, doing no work whatsoever. The correct answer is, in fact, House of Wax.
Oh, so close! I knew it had wax in Paris.
House of Wax is the name of that movie, which means you didn't get it right.
You would say she starred in it?
I don't know.
She didn't really star. She got murdered pretty early on.
Spoilers. Steve wrote that. Steve wrote that question. He's a big Paris Hilton fan.
House of Wax. Oh, that movie was terrible. All right.
She was the star of Wax Museum, though. She was in it all the way. It's
true.
It was a documentary. She narrated it. So
we have a dog down here too.
Oh yeah. Ollie.
Who has a dog?
Right here.
Ah, gorgeous. Russ and Missy, you got a dog too?
Not supposed to be down here, but
son of a bitch. All right. Well, that means Anastasia and Austin, congratulations. You're our winners tonight. Give them a hand, everybody. You guys are the big winners. That's the end of the show. Sing along with me, everybody. Well, all right. Okay.
All right.
You win. Okay. You are the champion. Well, all right. Okay. You win, but can you do it again? You won the game tonight.
Yes.
And everybody's feeling right. Good night, everybody. Thanks for playing. On behalf of Clofton P. Grudge, Katie Gray, Natalie Schaefer, David Bax, Ed Greer, Clee Wiggins, Sarah X. Dillon, Greg Nibbler, Anastasia Washington, Austin W., Missy Pruitt, Russ Kaz Kamerick, Steve Mandel, and myself, thank you for watching, and remember, all Republicans are evil pieces of shit. Good night, everybody! Mwah!
So close.
And that's the game. Alright. Alright, that's it. Wait, let me turn that off. Alright. So we're off now. They can't see us. They can still hear us. They're looking at the stream starting soon screen. Thank you very much. You guys were all awesome. That was a lot of fun.
Thank you. Yeah, that was a lot of fun.
I hope you guys had fun too.
Thank you.
Yeah, this might be our last show, but I'm glad it was a lot of fun. So I appreciate you guys doing it.
Oh, really?
I'm just, you know, over it. You know what I mean? I'm tired of fighting to be relevant. You know what I'm saying? Got to take a fucking break. All right. So thank you guys for playing. Good night. If we do it again, I would love to do it again, maybe for the next holiday. But I'll let you know.
Awesome. Yeah.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Nice to meet you all.
Yeah.